In today's tutorial, I want to show you how to generate wind speed and wind direction map in ArcGIS. Please remember to subscribe to this channel. Thank you. So, I have this data in Excel. You can see the station, the X coordinates, the Y coordinates, the speed, and the direction. So, I have this in Excel. So, let's save it now as CSV file. Click on File, click Save As. Let's navigate to the folder where we want to save it. Let's save it in this wind map. This is our working folder. Let's save it as station. Then the format, let's save it as CSV, comma, delimited. Then click on Save. Click OK. Click Yes. So we have saved our file now. Now let's open ArcGIS. In ArcGIS, let's bring in the data we just saved. To do that, come to File, come to Add Data, come to Add XY Data. Click here to navigate to that folder and bring in the data. So, wind map, this is it, station in CSV format. Click on Add. Then our X field is our X and our Y field is our Y. Then here, choose the coordinate system. Click on Edit. So I'll like to choose from my favorite, WGS84. So if you don't know, if you don't have it as your favorite, click on Geographic Coordinate System. Come to World. Then you see WGS84. Then click on OK. So you can see it's already added in the description. Then click on OK. You can see our data. Now, what we can do, if you right click and open the attribute table, you can see our data as we had it in Excel. So let's close it. Now let's convert it to shapefile. To do that, right click it, come to Data, Export Data. Then navigate to the folder, our working folder. So this is our working folder. So let's call it station. So, and the format is shapefile. Click on Save and click on OK. Click Yes to add it to map. So it is added. Now we can now get rid of this by removing it. So we can change the size of the symbol or change it entirely, and we can change the color here to any color of our choice, and we can increase or reduce it. Click OK. Yes, this is our wind stations. Now if you right click and open the attribute table, you see our values. You see the station, you see the X coordinate, Y coordinate, speed and direction. So let's close this. We can choose to label these stations. Click here and click on Label. So we can see our station from station 1 to station 10 here. So what to do now? Click on Add Toolbox. Scroll down, come to Spatial Analyst Tool. Click on Interpolation. Then click on IDW. Now, our input point feature is this station. Click on this drop down and click on station. Then our Z value, click here. Let's choose speed first. Speed. Then our output raster, let's save it in our working folder. This is it. So let's call it speed. Click on save. Then leave other thing at default and click on OK. So the interpolation is done for speed. Now click on IDW again, then load in the station. This time around, our Z value will be the direction. Then navigate to the folder where we want to save it. Let's call it direction. Then click on save. Leave other thing at default and click on OK. So it's running. Yes, the speed and the direction. We have generated the raster for boats. Now let's close this. Come to search. So come here and type create fishnets. Then click on search. So this one under data management, click on it. So here the outputs, click here. Let's call it wind. Click save. Then the template extent, let's choose same as layer direction. Then come here, cell size, let's say 500. Then cell size height, 500 as well. Then leave other thing at default. Check this create label points and click on OK. Yes, the fishnet is created. You can see it. So we can now close this. Then let's open this wind level view, right click and open the attribute table. You can see that the wind and the wind direction and wind speed is not added. So what to do now is come to app toolbox and come back to spatial analysis tool. Come to extraction. So here, extract multiple values to point. Double click it. Then input point feature. That will be our wind label. This one we generated. Then input raster. We are going to input the direction and also input speed. Then we click on OK. Yes, if you now go back there, right click and open the attribute table, you can see that wind direction and wind speed has been added to the attribute table of this layer. So let's now close this. So now let's close this. Come back to this wind, right click and come to the properties. So under properties, come to symbology and come to quantities. Then come to graduated symbol. And now the value here, we are going to choose speed. Speed. Then the number of classes here, you can leave it at 5 or increase it or decrease it. Let's say 4. Then come to templates. click on template and choose any symbol, then edit symbol. So when you click on edit symbol here, let's choose S3 cartography. Then I want to choose direction symbol, this direction symbol, uncheck this, click on OK, click on OK, then come to this advanced, so click on rotation. Now I want to keep it at geographic. Here the rotation point by angle, I want it in wind direction, so click on OK and click on OK. So I can now uncheck this wind here. You can see our wind direction. You can see our wind direction here. You can uncheck this and this, so you can see our wind direction. And of course, you can still come here, right click and come to properties to change the size of this arrow. So come to symbol, so right click here and format label. So here, instead of 6, if you want to increase it, you can increase it. If you want to decrease it, you can do so. But let's increase it and see. Let's say 8. Click on OK and click on OK. So you can see the result, it has increased slightly. So if you check this wind direction, we can also go to the properties and change the color. So come to symbology, so you can change the color to any color of your choice, and here you can format the label as well. Let's keep the number of decimal places to 2 decimal places. Click on OK, click OK. So you can see this is our wind direction map. We can do same for this also. Right click and go to properties, then right click here and format the label. So let's also say to do 2 decimal places. Click on OK, and you can also change the color here as well to any color of your choice, and click on OK. So this is the wind, and the symbol represents the wind direction. So now another thing we can do, we can come here, right click and come to properties. So let's label it the wind directions. Come to label, so label feature in this layer, and let's label it with speed and click on OK. So you can see it, though it's clumsy, so you can reduce it or leave it as it may be, or you uncheck it. This is our wind speed and wind direction map. If we take it to layout, let's choose a template for it. So let's use landscape and click on finish. Then we can zoom to layer. I hope this tutorial is helpful to you. Please subscribe to this channel for more videos. Thank you.